Dedicated, determined, dependable. Kathy Schmaltz, Steve Gruber, Joe Kopacek, and Tim Stout. Watch Channel 10, the news leader. Serving all of mid-Michigan, this is WILX-TV Channel 10.
Today, June 14th, 1993, on John and Leeza from Hollywood. Paul McCartney via satellite, just one day away from his first ever live TV concert. Cosby Show's littlest star, Raven Simone, makes the national debut of her very first album. Entertainment reporter Sam Rubin tells us the real reason Burt Reynolds and Lonnie Anderson are splitting up. Plus, Robert Wagner and Stephanie Powers are back together again on Heart to Heart and on stage for Love Letters. All this, plus a cliffhanger surprise from Sylvester Stallone. Today on John and Leeza from Hollywood. Now, please welcome John Tesh and Leeza Gibbons from Hollywood.
For tuning us in and checking out what we've got going on.
Let's just do this all day.
Let's just listen to this.
Let's just keep coming out and going back, coming out and going back.
I don't think we're going to get this all the time, but it sure is nice to help us kick off our premiere week.
You know, I was fine today until everybody, the whole production staff, they come up to you and they start going, so, first show, huh? Nervous?
Yeah, you guys don't worry about anything.
Not until you mentioned it. We've had a lot of good support, though.
We have. It's been wonderful because people have really been in our corner, and that does make a difference. In fact, my mom is here. My family, of course, has been very supportive throughout the whole career.
Hi,
Mom.
There is Jean. There she is.
Jean Gibbons from Irmo, South Carolina. I love you, Mom. I love you, Mom. Thanks for being here.
And that, by the way,
to
drive this cameraman crazy, that was my sister right next to her. There she is. Mary Ellen.
Hi, Mary Ellen. It means a lot that you guys are here.
Thank you.
But you know, our pals in the business have been calling too, and that does get you sort of nervous when, you know, people in the industry that you know say, you know, we're pulling for you and we're going to be watching. And
yeah, or break a leg, right? That's what we got.
Our staff.
Andrew, show us this thing here.
Our staff has been wonderful, and right before we go on, they bring us this thing,
a crutch, and
crutches.
They sign it, and it says, "Dear John and Leeza, break a leg." Thank you very much.
Isn't that great? Thanks, you guys. Well, we did get some videotape, I understand, that just came in from Sylvester Stallone to wish
us
well.
You know what this is?
I have not seen it yet. We didn't have time to screen it before we came on, but it is queued up in the control room, so let's share it with you guys.
All right, Sly. Sylvester Stallone.
Hi, you guys, Leeza and John. Yeah, I'm sorry I can't be there, but I just want to wish you well on your great new show, and it better be good, because after all the advertising I saw, you guys are really hanging out on a thin wire, and I know a little something about that lately. Anyway, I'm on the set of my new movie, Demolition Man, and guess what that movie's about? But I got an idea. Since I can't be there, I thought I'd perform a little movie magic, if you'll bear with me. If you'll go outside, look out the window on the tower, I've got a little present for you.
Oh, my gosh. Go outside and look at the, because he's talking about the big water tower,
yeah.
That we have here on our lot. You know, when we came to work today, I noticed there were a lot of cameras that looked like they were making a movie. Is that what's going on? Can we take our cameras outside then? Okay, to see what's happening. Can you guys arrange to show it to us on this video wall? Over here, guys! Over here!
Where is that?
Over here!
Where?
Over here! Over here!
Oh,
my gosh! Hi,
Hi, John and Leeza. I'm Georgia Phipps, and I did a lot of hanging around with Sly on Cliffhanger. He asked me to swing by today to make sure your first show gets off to a great start. Remember, as far as we're concerned, you guys are the tops. So just relax and hang in there.
She's on top of the water
tower.
Can
you believe this? Look at that. Look at this.
Good luck, J&L. Love, Sly.
Oh,
that's great.
Great. This is fantastic.
Oh, no.
She's gonna
no.
Out.
That water tower is what?
Look at her. It's 13, 14
stories high.
Now, this is the woman that did all those stunts in Cliffhanger, yeah?
Let's hope so.
Oh, this is such a nice surprise.
Oops, she just tripped over my name.
Oh, she acts like this is no problem.
This is great. I've actually seen a story on her. She did I think it was a 400-foot fall. In Cliffhanger.
We've got
twice.
To get her in the studio and ask her about Cliffhanger. And how Stallone talked her into doing this.
Oh, she's caught on the fence.
All right. Yes. Georgia, that was great.
All right.
She was hot.
You okay?
I'm fine. The figure eight is hot.
I bet it is.
So compared to the stuff you did in the movie, what was this, like nothing?
Well, no, it was really exciting and fun because not very many people have been on the top of that tower. So it was definitely an honor and very exciting. A great view of Hollywood and Paramount Pictures.
You got to see our whole lot up there, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
I can think of a safer way to get it.
Yeah.
Why don't you head towards the studio. We want to talk to you sometime during the show, okay? Thank you.
Georgia Phipps. That's a nice surprise. I knew that something was going to happen because when I came in today, there was a crane and there were camera crews everywhere, and I thought it was for you.
Oh, thanks. What I like was how stylish she was. You know? Not only does she climb the water tower, but she looks great doing
it. She was looking pretty good. So that's a great way to start out our show.
We have much, much more, though. And we have Paul McCartney via satellite backstage at Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia. It's the next to last stop on his new world tour. Going to get a chance to talk to him. I have a lot of questions I want to ask him.
Well, he's just one of our all-time faves, so it's so exciting to have him here. And Robert Wagner and Stephanie Powers are going to be joining us, also from satellite. They're on the set of a long-running hit that has been all over the country in many cities. You may have seen it. It's something called Love Letters. They're going to tell us what is the real story behind that rumored heart-to-heart reunion. Because didn't you love them on heart-to-heart?
They were great.
Jonathan
were great. What was
and
the name
Mrs.
of the
H?
Other guy? Max was the other guy,
Max.
Right? And the dog's name?
Freeway.
Yeah.
I love this show. I love it. So we're going to talk to them as well.
Also, Raven Simone is going to be on the show today. She's a little Cosby kid, and she's going to sing for us. Do a rap tune, I think. Well, I think it's a rap tune.
But, everybody's doing albums.
Yep.
This is great. Okay, well, this will be a first ever preview then,
you know,
I think, of Raven.
Did you see Jurassic Park, by the way?
I saw Jurassic Park over the weekend. I was one of the people standing in lines that went around the block for this. Yeah. It was a
huge film.
A big success, one of the biggest openings ever it had over the weekend.
It's also on the cover of every single magazine.
And in all the stores, this if week. You were...
Oh, yeah, I brought you a present, by the way.
This thing. I'm always afraid when you reach back. Oh, no.
Just happen to have this in my pocket.
Which one is this?
This is T-Rex, Tyrannosaurus Rex. It's Disco Rex, actually. Disco Rex.
These things in the movie, these creatures, first of all, they're so amazing and so lifelike, and they were so menacing. And there were kids sitting in front of me and behind me who were maybe 6, 7, 8 years old. And I kept looking at them because I was horrified.
Yeah.
And I kept waiting to see their reaction. And one set of kids were loving it, and the others were just petrified.
It could be intense for, like, maybe younger than 10 or 11, but...
This is great.
Isn't that nice?
You know who else we have with us today is someone who's going to become a regular, one of our family members, Sam Rubin. A longtime entertainment reporter on television and radio here in Los Angeles. He's going to be our guy to give you all the latest behind-the-scenes news on what is happening in this town. So we're anxious to hear what he has to say today about the truth behind all that speculation that I know you've been hearing it about the breakup between Burt Reynolds and Lonnie Anderson.
Here he is with a tease for us. Sam.
Thanks, John and Leeza. We were going to do this from the top of the water tower, but we thought it was a bad idea. Anyway, everybody knows that Arnold Schwarzenegger is playing the last action hero, but who's the famous hero that Arnold has always wanted to meet? Actor Leslie Nielsen is getting ready to reveal several personal secrets in a new book. We'll preview Leslie's surprising confessions And what has prompted Burt Reynolds to bid bye-bye to longtime love Lonnie Anderson? We'll tell you about the uncoupling all of Hollywood is talking about. We will be talking about that in just a little bit.
All right, Sam. We can count on you.
Okay.
All right, we'll be back
Sam,
in a little
bit. Sam, you need a Jurassic Park toy?
Yeah, maybe I can come over and look at it.
I got one.
Thanks, Sam. We hope you're going to stay with us. A great show. And to start it off, coming up next, our first guest, Paul McCartney.
Paul McCartney.
Stick around. Tomorrow on John and Leeza, from Universal Studios, Steven Spielberg takes you screaming through time on Back to the Future, the brand new ride.
We're at the Huggies Open, where the competition has a wet diaper and is pretty teed off. Now it's Huggies' turn. With the revolutionary ultra-trim diaper, it quickly disperses wetness into super-absorbent materials that lock wetness away from the surface to keep skin drier than Pampers. And ultra-trim is nearly 50% thinner than Pampers, so it's comfortable for putting around. It's a hole-in-one for Huggies ultra-trim for the driest players on the diaper tour.
We have on good word. The first day of summer this year is well on its way. Widespread frolicking has been seen and noted. Playing hooky is on the rise, along with pitchers of Country Time lemonade flavored drink mix with a taste of good old-fashioned lemonade. And should you find yourself daydreaming a little more, just blame it on the season.
Are there some days your hair needs more conditioning, some days it needs less?
No matter what your hair goes through, Vanessa's always there for you. Vanessa, your hair too beautiful!
Vanessa Adjusting Conditioner tracks your hair's changing needs. Conditions more on days you need it, less on days you don't.
Vanessa, your hair too beautiful, beautiful! Vanessa, your hair too beautiful! Vanessa, your hair too beautiful!
No matter which kind of bandage you use, for faster healing, add Neosporin. It helps cuts heal faster, 4 days faster than a bandage alone. A bandage and Neosporin, together, they make it better, faster.
Double, double your refreshments.
So refreshing.
Double, double your enjoyments. Oh, no, single gum, double freshens your blood.
Hey, Jude, did you know that Lady Madonna, Penny Lane, and Magical Mystery Tour were never performed live in concert by the Beatles?
I did not know that.
I didn't know that. Great shot of Paul and Linda, though.
It's 1965. Yesterday, remember that song?
Oh,
do you remember? Did you and your boyfriend used to listen to that song?
Well, I didn't have a boyfriend in 1965.
Oh, you're going to tell me you were 12?
No. I was 8.
Oh, come on.
No, it was 1965. I remember, though, listening to that song and writing in my diary. Dear Diary, and Yesterday was playing in the radio. And
go ahead.
And my brother had a band, and they did. They played Yesterday. So those are sort of my memories. Obviously, you had a girlfriend.
Well, yeah, I was older. I was nine.
Because we're contemporaries. I mean, come on.
Anyway,
I should have lied. There was a great
I never should have started this. Anyway, Yesterday has just been named the most played song in history 6 million times since that year, 1965.
And as promised, Paul McCartney is with us today. In fact, he's currently on his 1993 New World Tour. He's promoting his new album. It is a great one. That one's called Off the Ground. We're excited. Won't you please help us welcome via satellite Paul McCartney? Whoa. Paul, they love you.
Well, Paul, it's not Shea Stadium, but almost here, huh?
Yeah, not bad, man.
Paul, this is great. It's our first show, and to have you on makes it really exciting. So thanks for doing this.
You're welcome. I was 11 when I did Yesterday.
Yeah, let's all lie, shall we?
That's right.
Tell us about this tour. You're at Veterans Stadium right now.
Yeah.
Tell us how this tour has been going.
Going great. We started off in Australia, did New Zealand, and then we've come to the US of A. And the audiences have been wonderful, enthusiastic, smiling, and we've been lucky enough to sell out. So what more do you want?
Yeah, my mom is here today, and she said to tell you, she was so excited, she said to tell you she saw you in South Carolina, and the whole family was there, and it was great.
Oh, really?
Just a little
Thank
review
you.
There from,
Thank you,
from,
mom.
From Irmo, South Carolina. I know you're actually finishing this tour in North Carolina, and you're going to do a live broadcast for Fox at the end of the tour?
Yeah, Tuesday night.
What's surprising is that this is the first live televised concert, is it not for you?
Well, I think Ed Sullivan's was pretty
right.
live.
Right, well, that was with the Beatles, but I mean, with you
that
and your
with
band.
The Beatles. Yeah, no, I haven't done it for quite a while, let's put it that way.
As always, I know you've got your wife and family touring with you, right?
Mm-hmm.
How are they doing?
They're just fine.
You and Linda have been together 24 years. I heard
have
you
we?
Guys have never spent a night apart. Is that true?
No, it is not quite true, but mostly we haven't spent a night apart. Just one or two here and there due to unforeseen circumstances. But yeah, we basically spent the 24 years together because we like each other.
It's just...
Good enough reason.
There you go. It's an exceptional relationship, especially more so given that it's rock and roll.
Well, hey, what songs do you get the most reaction to when you're on stage?
Live and Let Die is probably the most reaction because there's some big bangs in that. And people always love a big bang, as you know.
Get yourself out of this
one. Thank you, Paul.
Well, John knows, I mean, you know. But and then it depends really where we are. If it's a very young audience, the new numbers go down very well. Songs like Hope or Deliverance. Mm-hmm. But generally, it's the sort of favorite Beatles songs that pretty much do it. Sgt. Pepper, Let It Be, Yesterday. But in fact, I say that I think the top one is Live and Let Die at the moment.
So when you do this live concert then on Tuesday, you're going to be performing a lot of the new material and the Beatles songs?
Yeah, it's a kind of mix. We do a bunch of Beatles songs, a bunch of new songs, some old, some blue, some new, some borrowed. But there's a lot more Beatles songs than we used to do because it got to a point where I was either never going to do these songs again or just enjoy them as songs rather than kind of think, oh, you know, I'm trying to do a 60s package. So I'm just getting into them as songs now, basically trying to remember all the words.
You ever forget words on the stage, ever in your life?
Do I ever? A better question is, do I ever remember them?
Oh, come on. We've
no, yeah, I pretty much, I'm better than the audience, generally.
Good one.
You know, I've seen you backstage at concerts before you go on, and nothing rattles you. I mean, you are just the ultimate cool.
Well, you know, I mean, I've been doing it long enough now, but I should think I'll be a bit rattled Tuesday night, because that's live. You know, normally you're kind of live to tape. But when it's really live. But, I mean, we're enjoying the shows, and we're determined to have a good time. We're going to have a party, man.
Yeah.
Yes,
well,
sir.
You get a party next week, because your birthday's coming
right.
up, isn't it?
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
Well, happy birthday in advance. Paul, I've always wanted to tell you this, but when I was in a garage band listening to your music and playing keyboards, I was trying to figure out the words to one of your songs. It was Paperback Writer, and I thought it was Take the Back Right Tire.
So well, it works. It wasn't that, no.
That works.
I always wanted to tell you.
Sometime, John. Yeah, cool, man. We had a friend who thought that the beginning of Strawberry Fields that said, "Living is easy with eyes closed," used to be, "Living is easy with nice clothes."
It's such a great musical legacy. Thanks so much for taking time out of your tour to spend with us.
You're welcome, guys,
good luck
and
Tuesday.
Good luck with your new show,
Thank
okay?
you.
We sure appreciate it.
Thanks, Paul.
Say hi to family.
Thank you.
He's going to be 51 years old, by the way. We talked about his birthday coming up, and it's
That's
had
right.
Dick Clark. It's unbelievable.
He never ages.
And never had any plastic surgery. I just wanted to set the record straight for you guys, because I know that's what you're thinking. He looks great. Nice man.
Stay with us. Raven Simone is coming up next.
Be right back.
Did you know that the light on top of the Capitol Records building blinks out Hollywood in Morse code?
Michael J. Tasting ballpark beef franks. The hot dogs, hot dog club, and it's good.
It's where you thought they'd gone to retire, maybe to play shuffleboard, but they had other ideas. And now they're why most of your calls go to the same area code. Call AT&T now, and you could pay less for them. Spend $40 or more a month, we'll take 25% off your favorite area code, plus 15% off your other calls. Guaranteed, with no fee. But you have to call 1-800-426-4752. Real savings made simple. Just another part of the iPlan.
There's a hunger inside you.
You're hot. The sun is intense. You need something to take the heat off. So you go for a refreshing Snickers ice cream bar. Rich, creamy ice cream with all the great taste of Snickers.
There's a hunger inside you!
Snickers ice cream bar. Because all pain is not the same, there's aspirin-free Bayer Select. One for sinus, headache, nighttime, menstrual, and arthritis pain relief. Five completely different products, all aspirin-free. It's exactly what's right for exactly what's wrong.
Good as these cleaners are, you can spray and spray all night and day with them and still have lots of germs, because you can't clean germs. You have to kill them. You need Lysol Direct. Direct is more than a grease cutter. It's a real Lysol disinfectant, too. Just cleaning, you still got germs. Get Lysol Direct, because you can't clean germs. You have to kill them.
Deep down, what's the dirtiest word in your bathroom? Lysol Basin Tub and Tile Cleaner has twice the cleaning power of the original formula to wipe out soap scum. And it even gets rid of germs. Get your bathroom deep down clean with Lysol Basin Tub and Tile Cleaner.
She witnessed what innocent eyes should not have seen.
No! No!
He envisioned his worst nightmare.
Plundering is inevitable.
So you think you know who's causing all their grief? Guess again.
All of your questions will be answered very soon.
The answer may shock you.
No! No!
This week on Another World, NBC Daytime.
From Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas, Ahmad Rashad hosts an exciting new game show that brings the fun of Las Vegas home to you. Caesar's Challenge, weekdays on NBC Daytime.
I'm not a control freak at all. I just want things the right way. Arnold Schwarzenegger, GQ Magazine.
He usually gets them the right way, too.
He does. Do you remember what you were doing when you were 7 years old?
In what area of life?
I'll pick the most disgusting thing you can think of.
I was probably running from my brother most of the time.
Oh, had one of those relationships.
I had an older brother and I had a baby sister at the time, so I was feeling like the middle child.
My sister, who is here today, is a little older than I am, and she and her other sister, my sister, I have two older sisters, and they used to, like...
This is good.
And they used to do this thing where they take your hands and they go, stop hitting yourself, Remember?
Mary
look at her.
Ellen,
remember?
Shame on you. Yeah.
So that's what I was doing when I was 7 years old. I was dodging my own hands. Stop hitting yourself.
And that one where they get your arm like this and do the burn where they're,
Noogie thing? Here,
and
how about some noogies?
Noogies, what is it? It comes
see,
in a handbook for brothers and sisters.
The reason I asked that question is we have...
I knew you were getting there.
It's because we have a 7-year-old coming out here right now who is, she's amazing. Raven Simone. How many people know Raven Simone from Cosby?
Well, I was here, she comes.
We don't have to introduce her. She's just coming right out.
My faves.
You move a little bit. I want to give her a
I hope
room.
The show lasts a long time.
Thanks.
Thanks, Raven.
How long would you like it to last?
A long time.
A long time. 10, 15 years, yeah, something maybe. Like that. Yeah.
We'll be on long enough so you can come on as much as you want. So, Raven, how you doing?
I'm doing great.
Yeah?
I'm very
you got like this hot career. What we didn't get to say because we were trying so awkwardly to introduce you was you've got a big recording career.
Yes, I do.
Mm-hmm. In addition to all the acting and stuff, so that's great.
The youngest solo artist signed to MCA Records.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, how did you do it? I mean, sure talent? I don't want to say that in front of John because then he'll really.
You mean singing?
Yeah.
Well, I like to perform. I like to sing in front of a lot of people. And I would like to hear myself on the radio and be in the top 20 or the top 10.
All right. Now, you started this business when you were really young.
Yes.
We've got today to share with our audience one of your earliest commercials. I think you were about 3.
This is the Ritz cracker thing.
You probably haven't seen it in a while, so here it is for you.
Who eats Ritz crackers in your house?
Daddy and Mommy. Everybody.
Even the goldfish?
Oh.
Just checking.
How cute is that?
I haven't seen that in a long time.
I bet. Were you, 3 years old?
I think so. I can't even remember.
Have you ever had any problems with nerves during a performance, whether it's a musical performance or when you were on a Cosby show?
No.
No? I mean, no. Never got worried about your performance at all?
No, not really.
Did Cosby give you guys advice? Because, I mean, I know you had to have a close relationship with him.
A lot of advice.
Like what?
Like, if you miss a line, just fill it in with a joke.
Yeah. Oh, no problem.
So there's these two guys walking down the street, right? One of those jokes?
Maybe.
Uh-huh. What about you? Do you give advice? Because there are a lot of kids who'd like to be where you are, and I know the parents are wondering if it's a good thing.
Yeah, I give advice about following your child's dreams and say no to drugs and stuff.
You have a little brother, right? His name is Blaze?
Blaze.
How old is he?
He's 17 months.
He is the cutest thing. I saw him backstage. He was into everything.
Yes.
He was like into the makeup drawer. He's so cute.
Is he also a singer?
Yes. When we tell my brother to sing, he does ah. And when we tell him to put some feeling into it, he does ah. So funny.
We have some of your lyrics here from the song That's What Little Girls Are Made Of. Mm-hmm. I love these things. Take a peek while I kick a Dr. Seuss mix. Tingling, a boom boom, a pock for your pick, Shazam, chick jam, a little rap, shoo to your choo choo, the middle rap.
How's he doing, Raven?
Put a little bit more flavor and, take a peek while I kick, a Dr. Seuss mix, tingling, a boom, a pock for your pick, Shazam, chick jam, the little rap like that.
Okay, let's do it again. You hold this for me so I can see it. Are you ready?
Okay.
Take a peek while I kick. A Dr. Seuss mix, diggling a boom boom, a pock for your pick,
grab your crotch.
Shazam chick jam, a little rap shoe to your choo choo, the middle rap flash, gobble zoom, gobble down my lyric, hunt for the double hunt, kid of the month.
Oh!
Is that it?
That's good.
Okay. Well, we'll get a chance to hear the master do it here in a few minutes.
Will you perform it for us?
Sure. Yeah, with my two dancers.
You have two dancers?
Oh, you brought an entourage?
I don't even have two dancers.
Woo, we are impressed with you, girl. Thanks for the roses. We're going to take a quick time out, and we'll
this is the world premiere, too. This is the world premiere of your song.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
All right, we'll have it for you guys next. Stick around.
You want everything that touches your baby to be gentle. Like his first friend and his first formula. We chose Carnation Good Start. It's different from other leading formulas. Good Start's protein is specially processed into smaller pieces to make it gentle, easily digestible. No formula is more nutritious. Remember, breast milk is best, but Good Start formula is made to be gentle. Gentle for you. Carnation Good Start. It's made to be gentle.
Sometimes you can't see what gets into your clothes, but you can smell it. The morning exercise routine, a visit with an old friend.
And to get those odors out better, there's new gain with bleach. It has odor-removing bleach, a color-safe bleach that does more than brighten and whiten. It removes deep-down odors for clothes so clean they smell like they were dried in the sunshine. They're sunshine clean. New gain with odor-removing bleach. There's no clean like sunshine clean.
Michael Jordan in Hanes Briefs. Michael Jordan in new improved Hanes Briefs. The new comfort of Hanes Briefs. Better fit, better feel, better than ever.
Just wait until we get a Hanes on you.
Now buy two packages of Hanes underwear and the new video Michael Jordan Airtime and get $5 by mail.
What would you get if you squeezed the refreshing flavor of this orange or this lemon into a nice, plump, Sunsweet prune? You'd get delicious new Sunsweet orange essence or lemon essence fitted prunes. Better hurry before someone gets yours.
Why Massengill?
Mother taught me never to compromise my standards.
Why Massengill?
I know it's gentle.
Why Massengill?
Trust.
Massengill douches, always first choice.
Massengill.
Trust it.
By more women.
Next time on Cheers.
Sam, could I see you in my office privately?
Rebecca will do anything to turn on her boyfriend, Robin.
Sam, I never thought it would come to this.
That's right, Sammy, anything.
All right, class, so you want to learn all about the wonderful art of love, eh?
And class, lesson number one calls for a little field trip.
The elevator?
Yeah.
Hey, who's teaching who? Next time on Cheers.
Monday afternoon at 5 on Channel 10.
Having a tremendous amount of pain in my neck, and down in my shoulders, down in my hands and my arms. I was having headaches, taking aspirins every 3 hours, and I was rubbing with Bengay and lanacane and taking hot showers, just anything to get relief from the pain. I feel chiropractic care is a blessing.
Her live. Here's Raven Simone with the world premiere of That's What Little Girls Are Made Of.
Woo!
Yo, 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 Raven's in the house. Let me see everybody get up off of your seats. Come on, get on up. Let me hear you say, go, Raven.
Go, Raven.
Go, Raven.
Go, Raven.
Go, Raven.
Go, Raven.
Yeah, it's 1993.
Little girl.
And it's all about her.
Little girl.
So here we go. This is another Dr. Seuss reproduction.
your back, the song is a hit. See what I see, see what I bring. And if you like to bring up the adrenaline, sweet like to see me, honey, don't shove. Cause I'm a pile of sugar, and this is what I'm made of.
She's got her own dances.
Yeah.
Congratulations. Great stuff.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah. I'm glad to see you're out of breath because we were a little bit worried there for a minute. Oh, you are so terrific. Thanks for sharing that with us.
You're welcome.
And come back when you release your new single.
Okay. Next time it's you and your brother, all right?
Yeah. All right. Raven Simone.
Ken Rubin, our inside guy on the scene, is going to be here with us. Stay with us. We are right back.
Tomorrow, Mother Love answers all your questions about sex in the bedroom. But up next, entertainment reporter Sam Rubin on his breakfast with Arnold Schwarzenegger.
For 1 month, I indulged in dark chocolate fudge, rich chocolate almond, and classic chocolate chip until I had nothing to wear because I lost 8 pounds. On the diet plan for chocolate lovers, new Nestle Sweet Success. A luscious shake for breakfast, another for lunch, a sensible dinner, and even a decadent snack for the same calories as other diet plans. Of course, you may need new clothes. It's the only diet that starts with Nestle and ends with sweet success.
My body tells me I might be, but then, you know, a woman's body is kind of, you never know.
And we're at a very nice age to start having them. 34, I'm 34, I'm ready.
I've always been ready.
The most important thing is my family, and that is having a child.
Negative.
Don't get worried, man. Yeah. We're gonna keep trying.
It's the backyard, the front porch, Amanda, Lulu, Aunt Gloria, Big D, and the kids' table. Now it's the area code most of your calls go back to. Call AT&T now and you could pay less for them. Spend $40 a month and we'll take 25% off your favorite area code, plus 15% off your other calls, guaranteed, with no fee. But you have to call 1-800-426-4752. Real savings made simple. Just another part of the iPlan.
No woman I know lets a yeast infection stop her, but just about every woman I know cures it with Monistat 7, the fast cure more doctors recommend to get over it and get on with it. Monistat, the cure more doctors recommend.
If you're taking the leading prescription medicines for asthma, ulcers, or high blood pressure, and you need a pain reliever, the one doctors recommend most is Tylenol. Not aspirin, not ibuprofen. Talk to your doctor about Tylenol.
Just when you need them most, the MSU Bootery is having a store-wide clearance. Save up to 70% on men's and women's shoes and sandals just in time for summer. A fabulous selection of women's shoes starting at $29.97. Choose from Rockport, Sperry, Connie, Bass, and more. A great gift idea for Dad, men's shoes starting at $39.97 with brand names like Dexter, Bass, Sebago, and more. So spring into summer feet first at the MSU Bootery in downtown East Lansing between MAC and Abbott during the incredible store-wide sale.
MSU.
I think if I'd had the audience's help on that rap thing with Raven Simone...
Oh, no, you were so good with the rap.
I think it would have been right with it.
I've never seen that side of you. I'm looking for the clothes to change next.
Hopefully you'll never see it again.
You know, a lot of stuff going on in Hollywood. We're going to shake it down for you because our entertainment reporter, Sam Rubin, is on the inside, and the gossip is swirling, and the deals are closing, and Sam, the man, has it all.
Yes, and we're going to talk a lot today about Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Did I hear that you had breakfast with him?
I had breakfast with him. I don't mean to name drop, but I did have breakfast with him. And the thing about having breakfast with Arnold Schwarzenegger is that he cuts his food before he eats You know, it's like a big European, and in perfect bite-sized chunks.
It's that control thing.
It's that control thing. And he cuts your food, too, whether you want to do it or not. If you're sitting at the table, he is slicing away.
And did he eat like a lot?
He ate like a lot. He had, gosh, what, I can't even recall, pancakes and an omelet and the big sausages.
Bratwurst.
Bratwurst.
And you had, breakfast? Of course, the fruit
breakfast.
Platter.
I had the fruit platter, yes, just the discreet platter. But, you know, Arnold, of course, is going to be with the two of you a little later on.
Mm-hmm. Later in the week.
Later in the week. But, boy, Arnold is very nervous about this last action hero.
Really?
Because he has invested so much of his time and his energy and his efforts into this film. And this is a very, very big week for Arnold. It is the opening week of his anxiously awaited film, Last Action Hero. And as you would expect with a movie of this size, there's a great deal of controversy surrounding it. You may have heard reports of a test screening a few months ago that was a disaster. Well, Arnold himself wants you to know that those reports aren't true. He told me, and he wants me to tell you, and of course, one does whatever Arnold asks, that this supposed screening never took place. Right now, preview screenings are taking place. Let me tell you also that Last Action Hero is a movie that Arnold fans are going to be debating about all summer long. But there is no debate that a star of Arnold's stature could probably pick up the phone and arrange to meet any star in the world. In fact, Arnold called in several celebrity favors for cameo roles, Leeza Gibbons, in the film. But there is one star Arnold has never met, and boy, would he like to. Arnold says he would just love to shake the hand of Marlon Brando. Arnold says that Brando is one of his biggest inspirations, and meeting him would be a dream come true. As we were just talking about, Arnold owns so many restaurants, maybe he should invite Marlon Brando to dinner, or maybe not. Now, of course, if you eat too fast during any meal, you might develop a slight case of indigestion, and this rather unappetizing topic is one that actor Leslie Nielsen will address in a new book that he's writing, comes out later this month. Now, why is the Naked Gun star an expert on the troubles of a sour stomach? Well, as anyone who knows Leslie knows all too well, the star always carries a handheld whoopee cushion right in his palm so he can simulate the sounds of gastrointestinal distress at a moment's notice. Leslie says some people find the personal sound effect machine hysterical. Others find it terribly vulgar. Either way, a proud to publicly pass wind, Leslie says, quote, I never travel alone. And from the silly to the very serious, what is the real reason that one of Hollywood's hottest couples will find their next get-together in divorce court? Everyone is trying to find out the genuine reason that Burt Reynolds served Lonnie Anderson with divorce papers. People who watch the now star-crossed couple point to the fact that early last week, Lonnie announced she was returning to regular work as a star of the NBC sitcom Nurses. Well, a mere 2 days later, she received her own discharge papers, not from a fictional hospital, but from her husband of several years. Burt says publicly that the marriage is ending because he and Lonnie see their priorities differently. Many are wondering if that is a thinly veiled effort on Burt's part to say that he didn't want his wife spending too much time in the studio and not spending enough time with their son. John and Leeza, certainly everyone in town is talking about this, mm-hmm. and I suspect at some point the real story will emerge.
It's bad enough to go through a time like this and then to have all of Hollywood talking about it is even rougher. I feel sorry for them.
And you know, what happens now is it really puts the two stars in an interesting and a difficult situation, because do you want to let people kind of speculate about it, or do you really sort of want to come mm-hmm. forward and say what right. it's about? And in the next week or two, particularly next Monday, you're going to see all the tabloids with they'll be on the cover, things like that. So it is a difficult time.
Right. Mm. Thank you, Sam.
Okay.
And thank you for being our entertainment reporter.
Happy to
glad to have you aboard.
Appreciate it. We're going to be back in just a few minutes and visit with one of Hollywood's most enduring couples, Robert Wagner and Stephanie Powers.
Stay with
right
us.
Here.
Guess where Jodie Foster keeps her two Oscars? Where everyone can see them, of course. In the bathroom.
9 out of 10 dentists report patients don't brush long enough, which could lead to ugly tartar buildup. The solution? Regular checkups and a tartar control toothpaste that's not only clinically proven, but also tastes great. Like Aquafresh. Look, the American Dental Association says Aquafresh is an effective decay preventive dentifrice that has been shown to reduce the formation of tartar with a taste that helps keep your family brushing. 9 out of 10 dentists ought to like that. Aquafresh, it's striped to fight.
What's making these watermelons wiggle?
New watermelon jello!
Wiggle, wiggle!
Jello
makes watermelon wiggle!
Now all the cool fruity taste of water watermelon is in new Jell-O watermelon gelatin.
Jell-O, Reese's watermelon wiggle. Jell-O, Reese's watermelon wiggle. Wiggle, wiggle. Jell-O.
It's wiggalicious.
And hey, no pain.
Reese's watermelon wiggle.
Now you can have your fun and eat it too.
When America goes on vacation, that's when I go to work. Problem is, it's also when I get really tough allergies. Not just sneezing and watery eyes, but sinus pain and pressure. I tried another allergy medicine, but it didn't work on all my symptoms.
That's why there's Tylenol Allergy Sinus. Its three powerful medicines relieve more symptoms than the leading allergy medicine.
Out here, I need something that works. Because this job isn't just a walk in the park.
Tylenol Allergy Sinus. Allergy relief clear to your sinuses.
So you think your dishes are clean, do you? Look closer.
Rinse water can redeposit detergent and food particles on your dishes.
Unless you use new Jet Dry to help rinse them away.
New Jet Dry for shiny, clean dishes.
I feel good inside and out.
Summer's Eve Douche. Specially formulated to work with your body's own cleansing process so you can feel cleaner, faster, naturally better.
A little help and I'm back to me.
Summer's Eve. For the clean that's more like you.
Later this week, Barry Manilow, Drew Barrymore, Michael Damian, and Halle Berry on John and Leeza from Hollywood.
One of the things we want to do as often as possible on this show is take you behind the scenes of the most talked about exciting productions in film, music, television, or on stage.
Today's a real great example of that because right now we're going to go via satellite to the set of the hit play Love Letters, where Robert Wagner and Stephanie Powers are standing by to talk to us. Hi, you guys.
Congratulations on your show. We're very proud to be on the first one.
Thank you.
A lot of people have seen this play across the country. I think it may be in 30 cities, Love Letters, but you two have performed it really longer than anybody else. Is it 250 performances?
About.
How do you keep it fresh?
But who's counting?
Well, the audience keeps us fresh all the time.
You know, you guys are such professionals, and because you know each other so well, I'm sure there's a comfort zone with performing together. But is there ever a time when it just falls apart? Any horror stories on stage?
Well, you know, if it does fall apart, it's nice to have a partner like her to kind of pick you up a little bit. So far, we haven't had anything like that.
No, we have no set, so no set can fall down. We don't stand up, so we can't have any major crashing into anything.
We don't have any props.
We have no props, so we can't drop anything.
That's right. So there you go. This is like the mistake-proof production.
Well, almost.
Before we came to you guys on the satellite, we were asking our audience about Heart to Heart, if there were any fans. Of course, everybody has seen that show, and they're all going crazy, very anxious to see you with us. But there's a Heart to Heart reunion that we need to talk about.
Yeah, what is
yes,
happening?
There is, John.
Is it going to go?
Yes, it is, Leeza. We've made an arrangement with NBC. We're going to make 4 2-hour movies of Heart to Heart. And Steph and I will be back together, along with Lionel Stander, who played Max. And the first show will be on November 5th, I believe, isn't it?
Yeah, that's the
that is great. How will the relationship between the hearts have changed? I mean, it was such a romantic show. I mean, I hope that's still going to be a big part of it.
I think it will be. I think it will be.
It'll definitely be a romantic adventure.
Now, you guys, in the old days, you guys were rich on the show.
Hearts.
The hearts were rich.
Mm-hmm.
Is it the same thing for the 90s?
Well, we're going to start it off with his being in trouble with his company. But he's always used his money. You know, he was a self-made man, and he used his money to really kind of help other people and keep his company going. And there's a lot of issues that we can deal with now that we couldn't deal with in the early 80s, you know, that not so much action in this one, maybe more character development and revelation.
And romance.
And romance, yes.
The way she says that.
I know. Something we all need.
The thing I always love about the show is Darling. I always wanted to be called Darling.
Well, now, I heard a rumor that Freeway is no longer with us, the dog. Is that right?
Oh, unfortunately. He's in doggy heaven.
So Freeway
was the Freeway was the first dog we cast, and he was about 8 years old then. And
He was a rescue from a pound. So it shows you it always pays to rescue something from a pound.
Hey, you guys, you know, you've been so successful independently and as a team. We're starting out this deal as a team. What kind of advice do you have for us on how to have that kind of longevity?
Advice.
Advice.
Oh, that's a very dangerous thing to give advice.
You two shouldn't have any trouble. All you have to do is respect and love each other. It's very easy.
All right.
We got plenty of that. And thank you so much for helping us kick off our show.
Good luck with Love Letters.
Welcome to the Heart to Heart Reunion on TV.
Good luck with the show.
Thank you.
Stay with us. We will be right back. Woo!
Wednesday, Wild Man Howie Mandel gets crazy with John and Leeza from Hollywood.
If you're a member of a company-approved retirement association, auto owners may be able to save you money on your auto insurance. With the new Auto Owners A-Plus program, you may be eligible to receive a substantial discount on your automobile insurance. To find out if your group or association qualifies for the Auto Owners A-Plus program, call the No Problem people today.
Protect your life, home, and business with the David Chapman Agency in Lansing. Call today.
Hello. Your donations have enabled us to refurbish homes, provide food, and other goods for needy families, all through telemarketing and live entertainment shows. Our telemarketing is provided by ADC and SSI recipients, the less fortunate helping the less fortunate. We also create gift dollars for the State of Michigan Department of Social Services, where they're rerouted to help your area needy. So please join us for 1993 and help your area homeless. And for those of you that already have, thank you.
He thought he was alone.
What the hell are you doing here?
I came here to be alone.
Until.
Are you telling me that we're just stuck here?
Stop acting like a spoiled brat and make the best of a bad situation.
They're trying to ignore each other. Or are they? When the tension melts, things start to heat up. Days of Our Lives, NBC Daytime, is getting good.
A fatal attraction places an innocent family at stake, forcing one mother to fight back for her daughter. Barbara Eden, Loretta Swit, Hell Hath No Fury on NBC tonight.
The Remington Microscreen Elite, contemporary design with twin screens and 112 diamond honed cutting edges for quick, close, comfortable shaves. Remington.
Remember at the top of the show, we had that incredible stunt that Sylvester Stallone had arranged for us. Well, we have the woman in the studio now. She's okay. And she's here to talk to us about that and some other things. Georgia Phipps has dropped by. Dropped by, I guess, is the right word to put it.
Now, I was reading somewhere where you didn't start out as a stunt woman, right?
No, I had never done any stunts before, just a climber, climbing for a long time, and was a dancer before that, but I did a lot of stunts on Cliffhanger.
How did they find you, the folks at Cliffhanger?
Well, they had called a place where I worked and had sponsored me through climbing and asked for stunt people and riggers, and I sent my pictures in and my resume, and through the process from the director and the producer seeing my photos and the rigging crew saying this is a good person to do it, it just came together. But I waited like 4 months till I got the word. And
that is so great.
These are whole movies that we're showing right now that your fiance shot of you doing the stunt, one of them in Cliffhangers.
Right.
So is that you with your legs dangling?
Yes, that's me.
This is just unbelievable. And this does not frighten you at all.
Well, look at this. How long a fall is this?
That's 400 feet at least.
What
did you land on?
Just in the air.
You had a line there, right?
Yeah, just a very small 3/16 inch cable, which is tiny. It's really small.
And what do you weigh, about 100 pounds or less?
A little bit more.
Wow.
Amazing stuff. Is there anything that frightens you?
Well, I have spiders kind of frighten me, but I'm working on getting over that fear, but they still...
Okay, Georgia.
Big spiders are...
Well, it meant a lot to us for you to be here on our opening day, and it was such a great stunt. Have you climbed the water tower?
Yeah, that was exciting.
It really was.
Yeah.
Georgia, thanks so much. Really nice to meet you.
All right.
Cliffhanger's doing great, so
good.
Congratulations on that.
Thanks.
Yeah, take care. Congratulations on your upcoming wedding.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you, Georgia. Good luck to you.
Okay.
Stay safe, okay?
Okay, thanks.
Stick around. Take a quick time out and be right back.
What is this thing you got on here?
Park Overall, the outrageous nurse from Empty Nest, joins John and Leeza tomorrow.
You see them at dawn talking about the weather, and if you look hard enough, you're back there with them. Now they're why most of your calls go to one area code. Call AT&T and you could talk to them for less. Spend $40 a month and we'll take 25% off your favorite area code, plus 15% off your other calls, guaranteed, with no fee. But you have to call 1-800-426-4752. 25% off where it really matters. Just another part of the I plan.
Creative cooks come from all over to compete in the annual Q Fest. These cookout kings and queens are masters on the grill. To beat competition this tough, it takes a great cook. And to beat tough, greasy food stains, it takes a great detergent, like Tide with grease releasers. For getting out barbecue chicken, no regular powder beats Tide. So to clean tough, greasy food stains, go with the winner. If it's got to be clean, it's got to be Tide.
Take Kraft Ranch Dressing. Throw in the taste of rich sour cream. Conjure up a minced onion. And what do you get? New Kraft Sour Cream and Onion Ranch Dressing. Its mystifyingly unique, cool, and creamy taste will make salad lovers everywhere describe it as truly magical. Sour Cream and Onion Ranch. New from Kraft.
It's new, and it's extraordinary, and it's gonna make you feel like you've never felt before. It's herbs and it's spices, and you'll know it the moment it touches your lips. It's chamomile, cinnamon, rose hips, and hibiscus to soothe your body and revive your spirit. It's new Nesty Instant Herb Iced Tea. It's everything you've been thirsting for, so come on and taste the plunge.
Only one day old. Our show is only one day old,
and we got
our own. Uh-oh, it broke it. Well, we had our own tissue box.
Our own tissue box. Yeah, I'm very impressed.
The John and Leeza tissue box. I had fun today.
Good time today.
A lot of good people on today's
show. I hope to be sitting here with you for a long time.
It would be my pleasure. Thank you. You're a great partner. Thank you very much.
We're looking forward to having some fun. And we thank you guys for dropping in on our first show. And we sure hope you're going to come back tomorrow, because here's what we got lined up for you. Steven Spielberg.
Yep. Ooh.
Ooh, I know.
Jurassic Park guy. Park Overall from Empty Nest, she'll also be here.
You're going to get some no-nonsense type advice from a lady named Mother Love. She'll get you going.
And our guy Sam Rubin will also be here with the latest entertainment news. Thanks so much for sharing our first day with us. Thank the audience here for being so cool with us.
Appreciate all of your support. And we will see you right back here again tomorrow. Till then, take care.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Moves to Thursdays after Seinfeld.
Well, I like watching TV 10 News because I like Steve Gruber. He's young, cute, and he knows what he's talking about.
I watch the 11 o'clock news on Channel 10 almost nightly because I like the complete coverage they provide and the presentation by all of the staff.
I enjoy watching TV 10 because I enjoy Tim's style.
The reason I like watching Channel 10 News is they do a good job covering what's happening in Lansing.
Join the growing number of mid-Michigan viewers who choose the new TV 10 Action News.
Don't miss Vermeulen's 12-month interest-free sale going on now.